All right, man, we back. Marcy Sports talking. The Detroit Lions finally cut Jalen "TEEZ" TABOR. Bob Quinn said enough is enough. They already have other cornerbacks on the roster that's by far better than TABOR, from the rookie Agwakwe, who got hurt last night. I'm not sure if he came back. They also got Justin Coleman, who they just signed, Darius Slay, Rashad Melvin, just to name a few. And Bob Quinn finally said, you know what, this kid just not a football player at cornerback in this league. And he got cut along with Andrew Adams, which he was on the chopping block, but he has just been making a ton of interception and turnover plays in practice in the game. So he'd be picked up by another team. But they finally cut TABOR. I was wondering, what did TABOR have on the organization? He have a tape, or he have, you know, something he was trying to bribe Quinn and the Fords of, at the end of the day, he just wasn't a baller. Sometimes you got to just cut your losses and not dig your hole deeper and deeper and deeper. And I credit Bob Quinn for finally admitting, he said, you know what, this kid just not a football player in his league. And what's so fucked up about it, and excuse my French, is that he didn't even get an opportunity last night to prove that he can play in this. He has improved live action. All we heard about, he looked good this offseason. He trained with Chad Johnson, a.k.a. Chad Ochocinco, and he still got cut. He got injured August 1st, then come back to a couple weeks later. And now, you know, his career is in flux right now. You know, he might have to go to Canada, or he might have to go, you know, finish his degree or whatever he got a degree in Florida. But he just hadn't proven to be an NFL caliber cornerback. Now, he might go somewhere else. They might run to Tampa too, and they might run predominantly a zone coverage, or they might, whatever fits his ability, he might go somewhere else and be serviceable. I doubt it. You know what I'm saying? But if he goes somewhere else and be serviceable, then that's an indictment on Matt Patricia and Terrell Austin for not knowing how to utilize his abilities. Okay? But, you know, Bob Quinn just kept giving him chance after chance after chance after chance. And, you know, at the end of the day, he couldn't prove last night or through the preseason that he improved. And, you know, at the end of the day, he just drafted this kid 2-3 years ago, and he ain't it. He was supposed to be the Robin and eventually probably the Batman to Darius Slay. He was supposed to be taking over Darius Slay's spot at number one, and they probably was going to release Darius Slay and not pay him and let him walk or end up trading him in the last year of his deal, and then they was going to rotate another young corner in there. But I was on record saying on social media that I didn't like the draft pick, and a lot of the guys in the SEC was like, oh, you tripping? He got great ball skills. I said, I do not like the fact that he ran 4.7, whatever it was. I didn't like the fact of that. You know, I've seen his skills, and he was making a lot of plays, you know, in zone coverage and intercepting and ball skills. But, hey, it is what it is, man. End of an era. If he goes somewhere else and do well, all blessings to him. If he come back and kill the Lions in some capacity or some way, shape, or form, hey, it wouldn't surprise me. But, hey, I just was wondering if I thought he was going to make it. Just something in my soul was like, they going to find a way that he can make it. But Bob Quinn gave him every opportunity to make this team. And I had never seen somebody so sorry at the cornerback position in the second round. A guy who couldn't even stay on the field for an entire game. I had seen nobody that pathetic. He was pathetic. He was going out there one drive getting torched. They was pulling him, getting hurt. He was pathetic. He goes on record seeing as that I can remember vividly as one of the worst players I ever seen put on a Detroit Lions uniform as a rookie. Not a diminishing superstar, not a former guy that was good and got injured, or a guy that was just bad because of an injury. By far, he was one of the worst draft picks I ever seen grace the field that had to know the right. Not an undrafted guy, not a guy from rugby or the CFL or the arena football. He was by far one of the worst. This decade, he was vividly the worst Lion I ever seen. Worse. He was terrible. You know what I'm saying? At least Killebrew was playing games as the safety, and he was on the field. He wasn't the greatest, but he can hang Jermaine. TEEZ TABOR is by far the worst Lion I can vividly remember that put on the Lions uniform, all right? But, hey, hopefully best of luck to him. You know, shout out to Bob Quinn for swallowing his pride and say, you know what, Detroit, I got one wrong. It's cool. They always get one wrong, but you got one right with Kenny Galladay in the late round. So, you know, it's all about wins and losses, man. So let's hope they win this season. And let me know what you think about TEEZ TABOR getting cut. Shout out to Andrew Adams as well, man. He'll find a place in this league, I'm for sure. TEEZ TABOR, I think he going to Canada, or he going to sell insurance. But one time for the one time, Mercy Sports Talk, we gone.